Introducing SmartX HCI in 360 seconds. With digital transformation in full swing, the IT infrastructure department is facing multiple challenges. While ensuring the efficient and stable operation of core applications is one priority, rapidly spinning up modern applications is another. However, legacy architecture and storage arrays are typically difficult to operate and maintain and require a significant initial investment. They are space and time consuming during initial setup and future scale-up, unable to support investment on demand and quick workload launches. The rise in hardware numbers often comes with an increase in investment and management complexity. Public clouds have superior elasticity and flexibility, but fall short in data security. How do you build a modern on-premises IT infrastructure that supports investment on demand, just like public clouds, is easy to operate and maintain, and can support various applications? SmartX HCI addresses these challenges with four critical capabilities. Capability 1, investment on demand and quick resource allocation. Compared with legacy IT infrastructure, SmartX HCI drops the dedicated hardware-based storage arrays and replaces them with SmartX Distributed Block Storage ZBS, which is based on industry standard servers and Ethernet switches. It then converges distributed block storage and compute virtualization into the same node. You can start from only 3 nodes and easily scale out as your business grows. Storage and compute resources can be increased online and distributed flexibly within clusters. HCI supports investment on demand and quick resource allocation, just like public clouds, while ensuring data security, simplifying infrastructure, and reducing server room space. It is more suitable for you to build on-premises infrastructure. Capability 2, support multiple hypervisors and hardware. To deploy SmartX HCI, you can use VMware ESXi in conjunction with SmartX Distributed Block Storage ZBS and continue with your current management, or choose the production-ready and free SmartX native hypervisor ELF to reduce costs. With SmartX Migration Tool, you can easily migrate your virtual machines across platforms. SmartX HCI provides software that runs on industry standard servers, giving you flexible options and allowing you to reuse existing servers. You can also choose our all-in-one HCI appliance, an out-of-the-box and easy-to-use product for more convenience. Capability 3, support mission-critical applications. SmartX HCI ensures business continuity and data reliability for your critical business from every angle. From data checksum for HDD, multiple replicas for node, rack-level high availability, to active-active cluster for data center, and cross-site replication. With a fully distributed architecture and end-to-end optimization and virtualization, cache, and network, you can now achieve the same performance as traditional storage arrays with a few nodes, and even higher performance by adding capacity. Through micro-segmentation of our network and security feature, you can easily build a zero-trust infrastructure to reduce the impact of security threats on business continuity. So far, 69% of SmartX HCI nodes are deployed in production environments of financial services and other industries, supporting core databases and critical business applications. Capability 4, intelligent operations and maintenance with zero downtime. With simplified architecture and intelligent features, SmartX HCI helps reduce IT management complexity and human error, and ensure continuous infrastructure upgrades. This is made possible with zero service disruption during scale-out and software and hardware upgrades, zero manual operation and automatic data recovery and data rebalance after scale-out, one click in resource utilization, log collection, and other operations, and one interface to manage multiple clusters and data centers. With these four critical capabilities in combination with our professional service and support, you can build a modern IT infrastructure that simplifies the entire IT lifecycle, including planning, configuration, deployment, operation, and O&M management. Over 10,000 SmartX HCI nodes have been deployed globally in financial services, healthcare, manufacturing, retail, and other industries, For two consecutive years, we have been ranked number one in HCI software market of financial services in China and named Asia Pacific Customers' Choice by Gartner Peer Insights. As a critical part of the hybrid cloud, SmartX HCI is widely deployed among large and mid-sized enterprises to build various resource pools to support critical business, modern applications, VDIs, robo, and so on. It also helps small and mid-sized businesses build modern IT infrastructure with proven stability, simplicity, flexibility, and desirable cost performance to support various applications. If you need help with IT infrastructure upgrades or HCI product selection, don't hesitate to contact us. You can also visit smartx.com/global to download our free community edition and join the SmartX community for technical support. Begin your HCI journey right away with SmartX HCI.
Hello everyone, thank you for joining us in today's SmartX webinar. My name is Anne, Brand Manager in SmartX. And as your host, I'll briefly walk you through today's agenda. As many of you know, SmartX HCI is our leading hyper-convergence solution that helps transform customers' IT infrastructure. But what does the company behind it look like? What is the positioning of SmartX HCI? Who does it compete with and how does it compete? What are the main advantages and differentiators? What does the product really look like? If you have these questions in mind, you are in the right place. Today's three sessions will start with an introduction to SmartX, the positioning of SmartX HCI, and our newest market progress. Then we will dive deeper into the features of SmartX and its four critical capabilities, and how it can support customers' critical applications, disaster recovery, and various use cases. After that, we will present a demo that showcases the basic functions and advanced features of our product. Now, let's welcome SmartX CMO Yinan to share his session.
Hello, everyone. Very glad that our partners and customers from many countries attend our webinar. I'm Yinan, in charge of the whole marketing of SmartX. I believe most of you have known our company's name, but still have a lot of questions about SmartX. I hope I can give you the answer in the following introduction. Okay, let's begin. SmartX was founded in 2013. Make IT simple is our mission, and we hope to do it by building an innovative modern IT infrastructure. Based on our distributed block storage, we have developed products including hyper-converge, pure software-defined storage, and cloud-native storage. Our founding team and key personnel came from the companies like VMware, Microsoft, and some big internet company like Baidu. They all have extensive experience in storage virtualization and cloud computing. We also got investment from famous venture capital and companies like Metric Partners, Vertex Venture, and Samsung Capital, Lenovo Capital. SmartX started business with a very clear focus on financial service market at first. The reason why we selected this market is that we think the FSI market have the most advanced and critical requirements for product and services. If we can win in this market, we can satisfy the requirements of most industries. Currently, we have more than 150 FSI customers like Bank of Communications and Taikang Insurance Group, which are one of the biggest state-owned banks and insurance companies in China. In Bank of Communications, the number of SmartX HCI nodes have reached 200 after 3 years expansion. For Taikang, they began to use SmartX HCI from 4 years ago and have deployed more than 100 nodes. So far, we have deployed more than 10,000 nodes totally. And many of our customers are the industry-leading companies, including manufacturing, retail and hospitals, etc. Our business may not look huge at scale compared with the other big corporates, but one thing worth mentioning is that our repurchase rate is as high as 77%. As you know, hyper-convergence is a very flexible architecture. Customers can use with a very small size like three nodes and pay as your business grows. So the repurchase rate is very important. The high repurchase rate means good product quality and services. Currently, our products have covered all scenarios of hyperconverge. Maybe some of customers and partners are still concerning that if critical enterprise applications and database can run on SmartX. The fact is that 69% of our hyperconverged nodes are used to run such kind of database like SQL Server, Oracle, RIC, and critical applications like HIS in healthcare industry, MAS in manufacturing industry, and online banking in finance industry. In China market, we have beaten the world's leading hyperconverged vendors such as VMware and Nutanix, and won the first place in the financial hyperconverged software market for two consecutive years. You can also see the Gartner has given a lot of comments on the stability of our products and the openness of hardware and virtualization. Outside China mainland markets, our footprint has also covered South Korea, the Middle East, Southeast Asia, and some European countries. The world's top manufacturer, Foxconn, has deployed 40 nodes to build the IT infrastructure of factory in China and Vietnam. The top e-commerce solutions provider in Korea, CAF24, has also expanded beyond 80 nodes. Last year, we also entered the Giggle Hyperconverged Enterprise Market Report. Unlike the SMB Market Report and the Edge Market Report, in this report, as you can see, except for SmartX, all of them are very large IT vendors like Dell, HP, VMware, and Nutanix. We have also been named the Gartner Peer Insights Asia Pacific Customer's Choice for two consecutive years. And you can see the actual evaluation and the comments of our customer on the official Gartner Peer Insights website. So why do our customer want to use our product? Because they just want to say goodbye to VMware virtualization. By using our hyperconverged product, they can save up to 50 on costs with proven reliability, ease of deployment and management, scalability, and desirable cost performance. As we all know, IT infrastructure is more and more important for modern companies because that's the foundation of all the digital applications. But IT infrastructure and the operating team always have to satisfy short and long-term requirements with limited budget and manpower. If you are using the legacy virtualization with SAN storage and VMware, you have to face the issue like complex planning and long-time deployment. Maintenance is heavy and you have to migrate the application if you want to upgrade hardware. Cost is high, which includes not only VMware, but storage hardware and rack space. But with HCI architecture, IT infrastructure gets much more cloud-like, flexible, and simple. You can only need commercial servers, Ethernet switch, and hyperconverged software which includes distributed storage and virtualization. With SmartX HCI, you can even get a free KVM-based hypervisor, which we call it ELF. Tasks like planning, deployment, operation, and maintenance will be much easier. The storage and the computing resource can be paid as your business grows and deliver very fast, so you can balance investment agility very well. The performance will be better, and the cost like procurement cost, rack space, and power consumption can be reduced sharply. Just like what Gartner has said in the latest report, hyperconverged has become one of the mainstream IT infrastructure choices now, which can enable hybrid cloud, edge, DevOps, and more. Of course, for customers, there seems to be more choices. There is public cloud, but most customers still don't want to put their important business data on public cloud, and network latency is also an issue for some latency-sensitive applications. Finally, for long-term TCO, public cloud also doesn't have any advantage. What about using VMware and Nutanix to build a cloud-like IT infrastructure in their own data center? That's sure if you have enough budget. But we all know that VMware and Nutanix are expensive. For SmartX, we will provide the hyperconverged product with the same stability and performance, but more effective cost, so most customers can afford it. Okay, my colleague will introduce more details about our hyperconverged product. At last, I just want to show the whole product picture of SmartX, except HCI, we have released the pure software-defined storage, which we call the SmartX CBS, and the container-based storage, we call it LMesh. We also released the product Everode to build network security protection for VMs. In the near future, we will bring more features and products for container and the Kubernetes to support modern applications. So customer can run almost all kinds of workload in one architecture. That's all for my introduction. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, Inan. A gentle reminder to our audience, you can post any of your questions to the live chat and our product expert will answer them. Now, let's welcome Edward, Senior Product Manager in SmartX, to dive deeper into the full critical capabilities of SmartX HCI.
Hello, everyone. This is Edward, the Product Manager at SmartX. We have released a series of products that enable our users to build a stable, reliable, and scalable IT infrastructure. Just as our slogan goes, make IT simple. I hope my presentation will help you understand the capabilities of these products and how they will help your business. Okay, let me share my screen and start. This is the landscape of our HCI products. You can see that it consists of storage, virtualization, network and security, and the management platform. ZBS stands for Z-Block Storage, and it's a distributed storage with high stability, reliability, and performance. We introduce ELF as a native virtualization hypervisor, and the users can also choose VMware ESXi or Citrix Zen Server as the hypervisor. When using ELF, we can also use Everode, a micro-segmentation product to control the east-west traffic. As for management, Cloud Tower helps manage all the above resources across multiple classes in different locations. The second part is hardware compatibility. We have tested and supported all the mainstream hardware in the market, and users can choose the hardware freely. Okay, I'm going to introduce the four capabilities that SmartOS can provide. the investment on demand and quick resource allocation, support multiple hypervisors and hardware, support mission-critical applications and intelligent operation and maintenance with zero downtime. I will start with investment on demand and quick resource allocation. When building infrastructure on-premise, it's important to start at a low cost but be able to scale out when needed. We don't want to spend 3 or 5 years of the budget at one time. When using SmartOS, 3 nodes are enough to form a cluster and it can be scaled online. After a node or disk is added, the system will automatically trigger data rebalance. In addition, when adding new nodes, we allow servers of different mix or models to be added in one cluster. Let's see some cases where our customers can greatly benefit from this capability. As you can see in the slide, some of our top customers now have around 300 nodes deployed, but they all started with no more than 10 nodes, 6 or 8. In the span of 5 years, they continued to expand more than a dozen times and indeed paid as they grow. Then let's turn to capability 2, support multiple hypervisors and hardware. We all know that hyper-converged architecture combines compute and storage services together, and a customer usually builds its infrastructure ecosystem around virtualization. So being compatible with their virtualization hypervisors would be a great advantage for hyper-converged software. When building the HCI architecture, users can choose a VMware ESXi or Citrix Zen server. We also provide a KVM-based hypervisor called ELF, which has both production-grade features and rich APIs for various third-party vendors to build the ecosystem, just like what VMware does. According to the data at the end of last year, we're happy to see that ELF's share in China market is already close to that of VMware. If you want to change your hypervisor from ESXi to ELF, we have a migration tool that helps migrate your VMware VMs to ELF. You don't need to install any agents in GuestOS. Just perform a staged migration, and it will be completed with a very short downtime. As for hardware compatibility, we did a lot of work and have made strict tests of mainstream servers, Dell, H3C, HPE, XFusion, Inspur, Lenovo, Supermicro, all work well with SmartOS. Such flexibility enables users to easily build resource pools in various scenarios. Many top securities and manufacturing customers use SmartOS with different hypervisors and manage all the clusters through a cloud management platform, thereby building their own private cloud that meets the requirements of production, development, testing, and virtual desktops. Then we proceed with capability 3, support mission-critical applications. As a HCI provider, it's our top priority to ensure data is well-preserved and protected. So we have introduced many mechanisms to protect data integrity at different levels. Firstly, we use data checksum to prevent silent data corruption. Then we place multiple replicas on different nodes and racks, so that if one node or rack is down, we can still find available replicas from other nodes or racks. Furthermore, we have active-active clustering and cross-site replication to consolidate the disaster recovery system. One of our hospital customers uses a 3-replica policy to protect their core HIS system, while using 2 replicas to achieve a better cost effectiveness for other applications. Another example comes from manufacturing enterprises. They use active-active clustering to protect their most critical applications, such as MES, ERP, and Oracle database. With SmartOS active-active clustering, they can deploy the cluster in two factories and achieve RPO zero and also recover in minutes. We also support integration with Zerto CDP when using the ESXi hypervisor. You can see from this slide that one of our fund customers has built its production and DR result tool on SmartOS. They chose Zerto CDP to protect Oracle database. Actually, this user runs almost all of its applications on SmartOS, and the mini computers and assistant have been replaced totally. There is no doubt that SmartOS has changed its entire IT infrastructure. In addition, we also provide a native backup and recovery service to protect ELF VMs. It's agentless and implements backup directly through the storage API provided by SmartOS. It supports full and incremental backup and can be managed through Cloud Tower. Users can also customize the backup and retain policies when needed. To support mission-critical applications, we also need high performance. As a HCI provider, the virtualization, storage, and networking modules are all developed by ourselves. We thereby have enough chances to optimize the full stack performance. And we are always innovating to take SmartOS performance to the next level. We have implemented features like data locality and automatic tiering based on a fully distributed architecture. Besides, we introduced the RDMA protocol to increase the bandwidth while reducing CPU usage. We also introduced the boost mode, which optimizes the I/O path between virtual machines and storage through vhost sharing memory technology. As a result, the end-to-end latency is reduced to the microsecond level. These optimizations can be proven by data. When you enable boost mode and RDMA, a three-node cluster can get 690,000 of IOPS and 14.5 gigabytes of bandwidth. Even if you disable boost mode and RDMA, you can still get 460,000 IOPS and 9.4 gigabytes of bandwidth. Let's take a look at a comparison between SmartX HCI and a medium-level SAN storage. We can see that three SmartX Halo appliances can already perform way better than HP's 3-part A440. Moreover, three nodes are just the minimum size to start with, and we can continue to scale to achieve both capacity and performance growth. By contrast, FC-SAN is limited by its controller and cannot make further progress on performance. Then we disabled all advanced features and conducted the test with lowest hardware spec. The test result is also significantly better than a HCI competitor. Both random and sequential read performance are basically twice that of the competitor, and the random write performance can be three times better. In fact, beyond these alpha-IO benchmark performance tests, we are more interested in how well will SmartOS perform when supporting real applications. The test results show that SmartOS can shorten the batch processing time of TA registration application from 93 minutes to 51 minutes, surpassing the combination of mini computer and traditional storage. In the test of Hanson 032 investment trading system, BPXP centralized trading system, and BI report generating system, SmartOS increased performance significantly when compared with the legacy infrastructure. Next, let's talk about security. With the development of virtualization technology, traditional firewall in data centers does not meet security requirements anymore. Therefore, we released a network and security product named Everroot, which implement a distributed firewall based on the micro-segmentation technology and can accurately control the east-west traffic of ELF virtual machines. Everroot is pure software-defined and is not bound to any physical hardware like switches. Apart from that, Average groups VMs with labels and security policies applied to the groups will follow automatically, even if the VM is migrated or any IP addresses are changed. Let's review more use cases in financial and other industries. Taking an insurance customer as an example, it has carried out 5 times of infrastructure transformation over 4 years. At the beginning, they created a cluster for development and test, and each node of this cluster supported more than 60 virtual machines. Just after a short time, it quickly started migrating production systems and built MySQL and Oracle database resource pools. The performance of MySQL database has been doubled, and the Oracle RAC resource pool can support 30,000 transactions per minute. Here are another 4 use cases. A fund company and a manufacturing company have replaced their mini computers and run databases on SmartOS. And the other 2 companies also ran their core systems like database or mass systems on SmartOS. Okay, the last capability goes to intelligent operations and maintenance. We all know that users of public cloud only care about using the cloud, while users of private cloud need to build, manage, and operate the cloud by themselves. So the private cloud must be simple enough to reduce the administrator's workload. SmartOS only requires comedy servers and Ethernet, which are quite popular and familiar to IT administrators. With hyper-converged infrastructure, data centers become very lean and tidy, with significant reductions in both rack space and energy consumption. I'm reminded of a customer's comment here. He said that hyper-converged architecture is too simple and streamlined. They used to have more than 10 racks, but now there are only 2, which look a little bit empty. I think this example is the best praise for our product. Speaking of operation and maintenance, let's talk about what SmartOS has brought to day 0, day 1, and day 2. In the planning stage, we only need to prepare 1 software package and do the corresponding network planning. When the hardware is all set, a 3-node SmartOS cluster can be up and running within 2 hours. In daily operations and maintenance, capacity expansion, software and hardware upgrades, log collection, all can be done easily with minimum manual effort. In this part, let's take a look at the case of a futures company. At the beginning, they had 4 Supermicro servers in 1 cluster. Then 2 Dell 740 XT servers were added to increase the storage capacity. They finally added their existing Dell 730 servers and replaced the Supermicro servers with 4 Dell 740 XT servers. Through this series of operations, they not only replaced the old Supermicro servers, but also expanded the existing resource pool. All those operations had been done without affecting the business at all. Next, let's take a look at the virtual machine optimization feature. After talking to administrators, we found that end users often apply for some VMs that exceed the real requirements. How to quickly find and efficiently recycle these VMs has always been a tricky issue for the IT department since it's very time-consuming. So we developed the VM optimization feature. Taking zombie VMs as an example, they are VMs that are powered on but have relatively few I/O for a period of time. We can quickly fill out these VMs with some basic configuration. In addition, we can also help users to find those long-term shutdown VMs, over-provisioned VMs, and under-provisioned VMs. Another thing we have done is using algorithms to greatly optimize data recovery and balancing speed. The algorithm keeps an eye on real-time workloads. When the I/O of the application is low, the system will speed up data migration, but it will decrease the speed immediately when the application I/O is high. As a result, the system could finish data migration or rebalance as quickly as possible without affecting the upper layer applications. As for management, we have Cloud Tower, which helps manage multiple clusters, making management work easy and efficient. Administrators can quickly locate target resources through full-text search. Besides, resources such as VM templates among multiple clusters can be shared and distributed through the content library, and VMs can also be migrated across clusters easily. We also provide a VM user view, which can help individual users manage virtual machines by themselves, thereby reducing administrators' workload. Let's summarize the benefits that SmartX HCI brings to users. From the beginning of planning and configuring, they can start at a low cost and get their business up and running quickly. In the deployment stage, SmartOS gives users flexible hypervisor and hardware choices. In daily operations and maintenance, we have achieved the maximum automation that can help administrators to complete various operations very easily. At this point, I believe you have understood the key capabilities of our products, and we are still developing more products to support more workloads and scenarios from customers. So next, I will briefly share with you our product roadmap. We will launch new products in four areas: storage, network, container, and disaster recovery. Okay, storage first. We plan to launch distributed file storage that will be provided in HCI, containers, and many other scenarios. At the same time, we will continue to enhance networking through EverRoot. We are now developing services such as network traffic virtualization, virtual private cloud, load balancer, VPN, etc. These services will be provided for both virtualization and container workload. We will also be promoting the SmartX Kubernetes service to support deploying and running Kubernetes workloads inside SmartOS Elf virtual machines. This service can leverage our reliable and stable HCI base, and users can also manage Kubernetes clusters easily. In addition, we will strengthen our data protection and disaster recovery capabilities by introducing products such as CDP, which will provide shorter IPU and protect users' applications together with existing active clusters and backup and recovery. Okay, let me make a summary. If we divide the customers into two groups according to their size, we will always find a place for SmartX HCI. For large enterprises who use the hybrid cloud architecture, SmartX HCI can be used in their on-premise data centers and robo to support the workload of production, development, and testing. For small and medium-sized business, they can choose SmartX HCI as their only infrastructure to host all of their workloads. I'm sure they will be very happy when using this powerful, elastic, and cost-effective infrastructure. Okay, that's the end of my presentation. Thank you for listening.
Thanks, Edward. Which of the four critical capabilities do you think is the most important? Let us know what you think in the live chat. Now, let's welcome Mu Yuan, sales engineer in SmartX, to present a demo using our Cloud Tower 2.0 on basic configuration, management, monitoring, active-active cluster, micro-segmentation, and other operations.
Hello and welcome. Thank you for taking the time to join us today. My name is Mu Yuan, pre-sales engineer over here from SmartX. My job is mainly responsible for the product promotion and the technical work in the overseas markets. So I'm here today to show you a brief overview of the Cloud Tower interface. Hope you will enjoy it. Cloud Tower is the centralized management platform of SmartX hyper-converged infrastructure. It enables users to easily operate multiple clusters spanning geographic regions with a single pane of glass. So there is no need for disparate management solutions for storage, servers, or virtualization. It has the ability to support up to 100 clusters, 1,000 hosts, and 10,000 virtual machines. This is actually version 2.2, the latest release. Accessing this through the Google Chrome, Cloud Tower is an HTML5 interface, so that means it runs on any popular browsers on any modern device, and it does not require any special plugins. Now, let's go and explore how Cloud Tower structures and works. There is a drop-down menu in the upper left corner, which shows different management modules of Cloud Tower, so each module has a corresponding interface. Here is the home screen of the Cloud Tower. You can monitor the overall status of your environment. It briefly tells you what storage do you have, how much is free, and how much is used, and how many virtual machines do you have, if they are running or powered off. It also gives you an overview of your CPU and memory usage, so you can keep track of that. The three wedges on the left displays the alert, the health status to your SmartX cluster, let you know if there's anything wrong with the infrastructure or anything you have to take care of. It allows you to click individual alert. To understand the cost, the impact, and the possible solutions. And when you hover over the physical disk wedges, it even tells which disk is unhealthy and its location. It's really helpful when doing troubleshooting. The main screen also includes a search field. So you are able to find information about the selected entities, such as VM, node, cluster, or even alerts and the tasks. In addition, the dashboard also shows data recovery status and the recycle bin information. Down to the cluster level, we even give you the performance metrics such as storage IOPS, your bandwidth, and your latency. And you can hover over on any point to display the parameters at that time. And here, on the left side of the Cloud Tower, we have a dynamic view for all the registered data centers and clusters of the organization. They are all displayed in a hierarchy. So this allows you to manage multiple clusters in a unified manner. So it's really powerful because you don't have to switch between the multi-consoles when you are doing configuration, monitoring, and management for different clusters in the real time. So you can handle most of the operational tasks with a simple click. The next I would like to show you is the hardware section. By clicking the individual node, you will understand what this cluster is actually running on. So here is the hardware information for a node, including CPU model, management and storage IP addresses, number of disks, and how many NICs are connected. And it also tells you the resource usage for past 15 minutes. And after it's associated with the IPMI, you would understand the CPU temperature and the fan speed as well. And we can even click on individual storage device. This is actually an SSD drive. So you can look at the performance metrics. And it really just kind of helps from a troubleshooting perspective. And if the disk is detected as unhealthy, you can easily unmount via the interface. Now, let's turn to the virtual machine lifecycle management part. The VM panel lists all the VMs and the relevant information, and allows you to access detailed information and change settings for each VM. The really nice thing is you can customize the view by clicking the GUI icon. You can display information for what you want. For example, the VM CPU usage, the memory usage, or even the status of the VM tools. When you click any virtual machine, a pop-up window will appear on the right side of the interface. So VM details, performance metrics, snapshot information, and the labels all will be listed here. You can do all the normal things inside a cloud tower. You can power the VM on. You can take snapshot. You can migrate this VM to a different host. And you can do clones. And of course, we can go in and change settings at any time. Again, you will figure out we try to do everything as simple as possible. Now let me show you how to create a VM real quick. Firstly, I give a name to the VM and provide descriptions if it's needed. We assign this VM to a user. And we can specify which hosts, or even let the system automatically schedule to an appropriate host based on resource usage. Next, we give it 2 vCPU and 4 GB of RAM. The other thing is very unique to SmartX is we support VM level and volume level quality of service. We can set IOPS and bandwidth upper limit for each individual volume. Here, we just keep the default setting, unlimited speed. We set capacity to 40 GB and storage policy with 2 replicas theme provision. Mount the ISO images. Add the virtual NICs and enable the high availability. We make it auto start after creation. Create and start. Then SmartX software is going to make that virtual machines with all the settings we just did. We also have VM tools that can be installed in the VM guest OS. So this enables some advanced features and give you a bit deeper insights of the VM. Here you can see the difference. For those VMs with VM tools installed, you can directly get the type of the operating systems, IP addresses, and even the kernel version. We also provide the capability to edit the host name, the DNS server address, and reset the password of the given account. So I believe the administrators will love it so much. Now, let's go. Let's go ahead and play around with the VM. We can do online expansion without any downtime. For instance, we can add more CPU and RAM to the VM. We increase CPU to 4 and the memory to 8 GB. Click Save. So this will be completed real quick. Okay, it's done. So next, I would like to show you is the live migration. So our latest release supports in-clusters and cross-cluster migration. Cross-cluster migration is very useful when you have multiple clusters. So let's do a cross-cluster migration demo. So firstly, let's select the target cluster. And set a storage policy as default settings. Next, map the VM network. Then use the hot migration option. Click migrate. SmartX will do the rest thing for you. And right now, a task icon appears on the right corner. So we can see the migration progress and how much time it takes to complete. The migration speed really depends on the network condition between the clusters. And we do have a lot of tabs that give you information you really need. The monitoring time. So this provides rich performance metrics, and it organizes and presents data in views and graphs. So you can monitor multiple entities, such as clusters, host, physical disk, and a virtual machine. Also covering multiple metrics, such as CPU usage, storage IOPS, and even the cache hit rate. So you can also get detailed information on what the top consumers are. So let you know the overall performance from cluster level to the individual disk. And it really helps from a troubleshooting perspective. We hope we've kind of shown you the simplest way to do the performance monitoring with built-in features. Snapshot plan provides protection for virtual machines by taking snapshots of selected virtual machines periodically. The snapshot data is stored in the cluster in which the virtual machines are located, and users can decide how many snapshots to retain and restore the virtual machines quickly when needed. So click on Snapshot Plan, and you can see the details in the pop-up window. So which VM is associated with this plan, and the execution record. You can execute or suspend the plan for right now, and you can edit the settings based on your need. So when creating the snapshot plan, you need to specify the snapshot object and set the execution policy. Let's take an example. So here you can set the execution policy by minute, hour, by day, or week. And finally, you just set the retention policy, which means so how many snapshots you want to keep. Finally, I will demonstrate some other fancy features of Cloud Tower. So in terms of the ISO images, we have a feature that's very unique to the SmartX. It's called Content Library. So all the ISO images will be uploaded to the Content Library. It allows users to share images or even VM template between the clusters. When you upload ISO images, you can decide which cluster to upload. So it supports multi-clusters. After click upload, the system will do all the rest thing for you. To share the ISO image, just click the edit storage clusters, and add the target cluster. The transfer will start immediately. So you don't have to upload the images to each node or clusters, which reduces a lot of repetitive manual work and saves time. Another thing is very useful to administrator is resource optimization. This helps customer to locate the Zabbix VMs over provisioned VMs or dead VMs. So what is a dead VM? The system defines a VM that's power state is shut down for past 3 days by default. So however, it allows users to set user-defined rules. So for example, we can define dead VM as a VM that is in shutdown state for past 20 days. So any VM that meets the criteria will be listed here. We even provide other indicators to let customer customize the rules, such as the CPU, memory usage, power state, and the storage IOPS. This free combination of indicators provides users with maximum flexibility. So our products always aim to reduce manual operation and maintenance work and help improve production efficiency. Let's go to the recycle bin module. The recycle bin adds an extra layer of protection to the virtual machines. For example, if a user deletes a virtual machine by mistake, the virtual machine will firstly move to the recycle bin, and the user is able to recover the VM before the release date. A virtual machine in the recycle bin are displayed here. So from this table view, you will easily understand when the VM is deleted, which cluster the VM belongs to, and how many spaces will be released after the VM permanently deleted. And of course, the rule is editable based on your needs. You can create special rules for each individual cluster. Another cool feature is a self-service portal. This is also fairly new to the cloud tower. The self-service portal basically allows you to allocate permissions to end users so that they can operate VMs with appropriate privileges. Here, I'm trying to log in as a virtual machine user that has been given the permissions to power on and power off the VM. Here we go. This is the view from the VM user. So you can see this user only has a very limited control on the VM. For example, to check the performance details, open the terminal, and shut down the VM. This feature allows you to create projects within an organization. So individual users or teams, such as developers, test, can provision and manage VMs in a self-service manner. Self-service portal enables users to do work and complete the tasks at the times that they are convenient for them, so without your IT staff having to pay costly premiums for shift work and after-hour support. Okay, because of the time constraints, it's all for today's demo. We do have many more features waiting for you to explore. Again, thank you for attending. We hope you have learned and enjoyed the session.
Thanks, Mu Yuan. This is the end of today's webinar. Thank you again for joining us. If you have any questions, welcome to join us on Slack or send us emails. And feel free to follow us on social media, and we will keep you posted with our newest updates. Thank you for your patience. Have a great day.